You hear me?
Yes.
Good. My name is Qiu. I come from South China Sea, and in Guangzhou, southern China. My talk is about the impact of fishing in climate change on fisheries. Climate and fisheries both impact on fisheries. But for climate change, there are direct impact from physical environment condition, and also impact through changing nutrient supply. And the nutrient supply will in turn influence the productivity of the oceans. And the productivity, primary production, I mean, will change the production of different level of the different trophic level of the ecosystem. The direct impact include warming on physiology, because warming increase temperature, we increase the metabolism. Metabolism increase the consumption of the body, will increase. That mean the production, the output for fishery will be reduced. And also low oxygen may affect the growth of fish. When the oxygen decrease, the fish may not die, but they will lose their appetite. And also warming induced polar bear shift. When it becomes very warm, the sun fish go out of your area. And also direct physical impact on larval survival in the equipment, because the future climate change might enhance heavy rainfall in development of, if the seawater become very fresh, the salinity decrease, and some egg might sink into the bottom where the oxygen is very low, and the survival rate will decrease. Also the acidification, we discussed quite a lot. And there are indirect impact of climate change. The indirect climate change influence the fish stock through changing ocean production. That is a bottom-up control. So the bottom-up control will influence every trophic level and the whole ecosystem. More and more evidence show the indirect effect through changing nutrient supply on production is more important than the direct impact. So the future fish production may rely on changing primary production in the transfer efficiency. The production may be changed, and the species composition may be changed. So the efficiency of transfer of the energy may also change. For prediction of the future fish production, it is very hard to predict because the climate, there are uncertainty in climate, uncertainty in the primary production, in the transfer pathway, in efficiency of the future. And there are also confounding effect from fishing and other human activity, because human activity, fishing, and climate, they can add together. So you cannot tell what is from the fishing and what is from the climate effect, and also human activity, because human activity, like in South China, the use of chemical fertilizer increase the nutrient condition. Generally the fish in the fish production in the high latitude may increase because the warming temperature is is a positive factor in the high latitude, because temperature become warm, the production, the primary production might increase. And also the sea ice will decrease, then more water is available for fish production. But generally in a low latitude, the production might reduce because of stratification. The water current become very stable. In a nutrient in the bottom cannot be come up to the surface. That is the worry, and we worry about the low latitude tropical area. But for Saturn, we do not worry about this because most of the nutrients come from river input. So that's the case in Saturn Sea. So I present a case study of the northern Saturn Sea. We analyzed the past change from 1950 to now, and try to find out the influencing factor in their mechanism. If we know what is influencing the production in how they operate, we can have a projection for the future. This is the South China Sea, East China Sea, Bohai Sea, Yellow Sea, and East China Sea. And from southward, this is the South China Sea. Northern part of South China Sea, because South China Sea is very large. The southern part is near the Malaysia and in Indonesia. You can see that in South China, in the northern, in the East China Sea, we have this from 1950 to 1980. The catch is increasing, but so quite stable. But in the southern tropical South China Sea, there is also an increasing trend. But the catch is very bad. Why it is so very bad? Because the environmental condition in the South China Sea is quite stable. The temperature of wind, there is no ice. And why is it so fluctuate? We think that is because of nutrient supply. South China Sea is a poor nutrient sea, so you have a nutrient pass, the production may increase. You see, this is the river system in China. We have large rivers, like Yangtze River near Shanghai. Shanghai is here, we are now here. And this is the largest river in China. It is comparable to Amazon River. And also the Pearl River. Pearl River is the second largest river in terms of water volume. And Yellow River is very long, but in the northern China, it is at the flow. The discharge is lower than the Yangtze River in Pearl River. The nutrients come up from these large rivers. Fertilize the coastal water of China, so it is very productive in the coastal area, but the nutrient condition is poor in the offshore area. This is the first filter that we should consider in our analysis, because it the river supply nutrient to the ecosystem, it can determine the production. The second one. You can also see the coastal area is more productive, but it is very strange. In summer, we have low production, and in winter, the production is the highest of the year. Why? Because in the winter season, there are vertical mixing. When monsoon is high, and the temperature is very low, the vertical mix means the nutrient come from the bottom, so the production is the highest in winter season, not in summer or in spring season, but in winter. We also have a strong forcing factor in the South China Sea, the tropical cyclone. The tropical cyclone can mobilize the nutrient element in enhance the biological production. There are many evidence to show that the tropical cyclone can increase the primary production. But before this, we do not know how it is function in fish production. The tropical cyclone can mix the water, diffuse the water out of the coastal waters in estuaries. The wind itself can mix the water and upwelling because it becomes very low in pressure in the water come up from bottom, from subsurface. The subsurface is rich in nutrients, so the nutrient supply from subsurface. And also heavy rain from land. When tropical cyclone approach, there are heavy rains, and heavy rain can increase the land-based runoff in the high production can be observed, both in the upwelling region in along the coast. Tropical cyclone is very active in the South China Sea here, also in other regions. The climate forcing factor we suppose include development of the effect may be positive because it input nutrient to the ecosystem. Summer monsoon is warm in the water come from offshore, from oceanic. It should be poor in nutrient condition and have a negative effect on production. And winter monsoon, I just mentioned, it creates vertical mixture and also tropical cyclone. It has a positive effect. I conduct an index for a tropical cyclone, that is duration, the time of action. It is severity. Severity can be indicated by the maximum wind speed or the lowest pressure on the cyclone. My hypothesis is that rainfall and monsoon in tropical cyclone is highly fluctuate, and in the climate variability, we have lag effect on fish production through controlling nutrient input in circulation in a prey for fish. That is the physical factor change the nutrient supply. In nutrient supply, we are influence the primary production. In the primary production, intense influence fish catch. But they have a time lag. Because when nutrient increase, primary production increase, the survival rate of the recruitment will increase. In the first knee, need years to grow, to become your catch. So there should be a delay, about 1 to 3 years. That depends on the species, in the age in your catch. Because we have a number of species in a tropical area, and I cannot analyze species by species for 26 species, maybe even more. In the South China, we have hundreds of species in the cage. So we use principal component analysis to summarize the variation. That is to classify into different type of variation or a trend. Then we get a loading structure. For PC1, they have law on some traditional fish, large fish, all demersal species. The second principal component also low on demersal species, but these species have a longer, have larger range. It is distributed further offshore than the species on PC1. And also there are loadings on other components like PC3, 4, and 5. They represent the fish or large variation. But we in fish, in psychology, in taxonomy, they focus on the analysis of the loading structure, all the components, and call the analysis further analysis in psychology. But in physical science, in ecology, we focus not on this. We focus on the variation of each component. That is the change with year all the component. Yeah.
What is PC? Just from PC, you have PC, the table. What is PC? And PC 1, 2, 3, what does PC stand for?
I saw you. PC1 is Chinese herring, a coastal species. PC1 includes several species, large species, large fish. And in this small pelagic fish have a negative. That means when the bottom fish come down, the pelagic fish go up. That's the negative. PC is the first component principal component analysis. The script suggests 5 meaningful component of aging value over 1. So we have 5 components for our analysis. We focus on the variation with time of the component. PC1, you saw, it first increased and then decreased. In the negative component, negative species, all of these components are increasing. Basically, they have opposite direction. In the PG2, large fish further offshore, it increased, then decreased. The decrease happened later than this one. This is correspondence to the increase in fishing power. When fishing power increased, the PC1 increased, then decreased. It's a Fox model. I feed by a Fox model or saver type model. Also, the PC2 can be fitted by another fisheries model. So from the fitting, I'm sure that there are fishing effect, PC1 and PC2. They are fishing effect. In the PG3, 4, and 5, they saw large variation and no trend or increase or decrease. It is correspondence to the variation in physical factors. So PG1, I attribute PG1 to PG5. The variation due to climate fluctuation. So through the principal component analysis, we can fundamentally separate fishing effect from climate variation. Then we analyze the fishing effect in the climate variation separately. The first component, first slice in decline. This is the coastal demersal species, because the fishery is first developed in the coastal waters. So the catch increased, then it decreased for a long time. This component is for the pelagic species in a small size species. When the demersal fish decline, the pelagic species increase. So these species have a negative loading on the PG1. This is another group of demersal species of wider length. So the decline goes later than this one. And PC3 to PC5 is the physical, it's because of physical variation. This one, PC3, is dominated by tropical cyclone with a time lag of 1 to 3 years, and PC4 by monsoon change in winter wind speed. Winter wind speed change 1 to 4 years later, it changed. And this component represents cuttlefish squid have only 1 year of lifespan. So the time lag is exactly 1 year. Yeah. Through lake correlation in degradation analysis. Okay. I will show you later. Because we have alignment factors like tropical cyclone, summer and winter speed, and also development of the rainfall. So we in addition to the correlation analysis, we also use degradation, but multiple variable degradation. And this metric represent the partial correlation between the PCs in the physical variable. For example, you see the tropical cyclone influence. The correlation are all significant. And there are different time lag. For example, for the squid in cuttlefish, we have one year time lag. And also we know there are fishing effect, and there are climate variation. So when we analyze the change in total catch, we first remove a trend. This trend is because of the fishing change in fishing effect, that is number of fishing boat in the technology change. So we first remove this trend, and the variation become this. And then we have physical variable to fit the variation. That is so. For total catch is here. R is the degradation. Is the coefficient of degradation for a multivariate degradation analysis. Yeah. 0.89. I present it in percentage. So yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. That's why.
So. One point is that if there are large variation, large catch, the variation is also high. That is the variation as associated with the mean. So you have to account this by coefficient of variation. Because when catch is low, the variation is also low. And when catch increase, the variation also increase. So you have to account for the variation to make it comparable. So we do not use the deviation, we use the coefficient of variation. to link to the physical factors. And there are, we have correlation analysis used TCI, that is tropical cyclone index, winter monsoon, summer monsoon, and also the development of, we do not have development of data, but we use the landfall data. And we also analyze the CPUE change for the most recent years, from 1980s to most present year. You see, this is the fishing effort, that is the total horsepower of the fishing boat. The fishing effort increased, and then the CPUE, the catch rate, decreased. But there are variations. And then we first remove this trend and account for variation associated with the mean. So we get it. We get CV or catch rate like this. We get the summer wind speed. But they are in negative relation with time lags. That is the variation of catch lag behind the change of summer monsoon. When we know that a large variation is because of climate variability. And there are trends, increase and then decreasing. So we can fit this model by a Fox model. We see that the catch of pelagic species first increase, then decline. But there are very large variations because this trend is because of the increase in fishing power. So from the analysis, when we separate the fishing effect from the climate influence, we can analyze the effect of fishing and the effect of climate change more clearly. The effect of fishing I focus on the climate change. When we have the fishing effect, we have management implication. That is, there are overfishing in the North China Sea. First in the coastal demersal species, then in the offshore demersal species, and finally, the small pelagic fish also overfished. So we have management implication that when we reduce the fishing effect, the fishing intensity, the stock will recover. That is from our analysis of the fishing effect. And also, the mechanism of climate influence. From analysis, we know that the variation is because of the physical change. And the mechanism is through changing nutrient supply. Runoff monsoon in tropical cyclone are the forcing factor. The physical factor influence fish production by controlling nutrient supply. This is a detailed description of the every physical forcing factor. Then if we know the forcing factor in mechanism, we can have a prediction for the future. Let's look at the, we know that the change in variation in fish catch is because of nutrient supply. Then we look at the future change in nutrient supply. You can see nitrogen from river supply is increasing in the northern South China Sea. this trend is because of we use a lot, a large number of chemical fertilizer. The liver water contain much nitrogen from agriculture use of fertilizer. The fertilizer not fully utilized by the agriculture come down with the river flow. And also we have large cities near the river, so the soil disposal also contain much nutrient. The nitrogen is the dominant nutrient. When the nutrient condition improved, the primary production in the coastal area also enhanced, because we have noticed that the primary production in the northern South China Sea in the safe waters has doubled since 1980s. In the trend is still increasing. The other factor that is very important is the tropical cyclone. Tropical cyclone is a counterpart to stratification. In a tropical area, we are very much worried about the water stratification. But the tropical cyclone is a counterpart. It can make the nutrient come from the bottom. You can see the tropical cyclone energy is increasing, but there are large fluctuations from year to year. And in the South China Sea, there are decadal change. There are interannual variation and also a decadal change. Go up in go down, and in this year the tropical cyclone has increased. And the possible future change in tropical cyclone when the temperature increased. The past change, this is the past condition, and in the future, in the next 30 years, the tropical cyclone in the South China Sea may increase the frequency. And for the next 30 years, it might become less. So there are decadal variations in tropical cyclone. When the El Nino-like condition comes in the future, the tropical cyclone will increase, but not in South China Sea. It is in the southern Japan. So the South China Sea might become poor in nutrient supply. So our prediction for the future change is that we have to reduce the fishing pressure. A reduction of fishing pressure will increase the biomass and production in the South China Sea. In analyzing human activity in input and nutrient, in the likely future climate change, my desire in an increase in fish production, because the nutrient condition is increasing because of use of chemical fertilizer in soil disposal. So I believe the trend, the input of nutrient from river and land will increase. And this will increase the primary production of the sea waters. And however, there are large variations in the tropical cyclone. So I believe the increased production will be associated with even larger in the decadal variations. That's my conclusion from the analysis. We are very sure about the future change in temperature, but no one is sure of the future change in tropical cyclone in monsoon, in heavy rainfall. So the prediction can only be qualitative, not a quantitative prediction, because there are so many factors that we don't know. What we know is the temperature will go up, but we don't know the monsoon, cyclone, and whether the rain become more heavy. We are not very sure about future trend. So that's it. Thank you. Any question? Eric?
Thank you. You showed some very strong relationships, very interesting with the physical forcings. I was just wondering, are there mechanisms that make sense for why you would find those particular physical mechanisms for the different fish species that are most strongly affected? For example, I think your principal component one was mostly tropical cyclones, which you say should be more runoff-derived nutrients going into the coastal zone. So does that fit with what you know, the species that clustered in principal component one?
That is largely based on the hypothesis. You know the hypothesis. The hypothesis is that nutrient input will increase the primate production in land fish production. And there are evidence to support that tropical cyclone we are increase primary production.
Why is it for certain species?
Why is it for certain type of species like the man? You see, PC1 corresponds to a certain type of species. Right. PC1 go up and go down. PC1 is the fishing effect. PC4, yeah. I will show you PC4. This is PC3 to PC4 and PC5. PC3.
Right.
PC3 represent tropical cyclone effect because this is based on correlation analysis.
Right, we were just wondering, is there something in particular about those fish that would make you think that it's reasonable that they're most strongly?
Yeah.
Or is there something for anchovies?
Let's look at the loading structure.
Yeah. Oh, I just mean like based on the fish. Like
PC3, these include hair tail, silver croak or small size, and also pamphlet or maybe pelagic species, and also five is that is so lifespan, so they have the action to the tropical cyclone.
Okay, thank you.
Will you please explain more about the lag between the catch rates and the physical variables? You have shown the lag of 3 to 4 years between the catch rates and the physical factors.
Physical factors?
Monsoon or typhoon.
Yeah. There are time lag between the catch in the tropical cyclone influence, because when there are frequent tropical cyclones, the primary production will increase. When the primary production increase, the survival in the feeding condition of fish will increase. But we do not catch this fish this year because it is very small. We have to wait for 1, 2, or 3 years to harvest the fish. So there is a time lag between physical influence in the harvest of the species.
But the lag between the
time of a PC series, the lag tends to be shorter than the total lag between the physical variables.
We don't wait until 6 years when the fish become very large. Then we catch it. We catch the fish or almost 1 year or 2 years, and now we catch the fish or 6 months. so the time lag may reduce. What's your question?
How some monsoon induce the decreasing of fishery catching data?
Catching data?
Yeah. How some monsoon induce the decreasing of fishery?
Summer monsoon.
Yeah. Why? Why?
Because summer monsoon is warm. It strengthens the stratification. When the summer monsoon come, the water temperature, surface water temperature become high. In the water become very stable. The nutrient from the bottom cannot be come up to the surface. So when summer monsoon is strengthened, the water become stratification. And also it bring the organic water from the south.
Sir, can I have a small question? Like in the PC4, we find like it ranges from anchovies to sharks. The size range is really...
anchovy, poaches, small spinach mackerel, lizard fish, and also sharks.
Yeah.
So there's trend. When anchovies and small size fish gather in the northern sea, it may attract sharks from far away. So the shock also increased. This is my explanation, but I'm not sure.
I think cluster would have been better. Cluster analysis.
Yeah.
No, I think, had you done cluster analysis initially and checked, so the similar species occurring, the similar niche would have been in one cluster, then you should have gone for the physical, I guess. That would have been better.
Maybe we can talk about that later. There's one last question,
Hadar,
if you want to ask it, and then we'll move on to the next speaker.
Any question?
You showed that in the winter there is more primary production than in the summer.
Yeah.
So I know, like from where I study, that there is the most primary production in the spring because of the light.
Yeah.
Because there is a lot of mixing, there come a lot of nutrients, but there is still light limitation. So how is this possible?
In South China, we have no limitation of light because the water is clear and the sunlight is very strong. We have no limitation of temperature because the temperature is very high all the year. What we lack is the nutrient because of stratification. So in winter, the nutrient come up in fight from plankton bloom. This is different from the temperate waters. The high production usually occur in spring, in summer. Yeah. Thank you.